In this part of the video, I want to show you how to design a great book interior. For example, like this one, you can design something like this. This is a great book interior which you can design, and I'll be teaching you how to do this in this video. This is one of them. You can also do this. This, you can do something like this. It's also good. Then there are others which you can do, which can be like this. Doing this thing is not easy. It's not easy. If you decide to go on a journey of making your book look great, then prepare to take more time on your books. For example, if you usually write one book in maybe 3 hours or 2 hours, then if you decide to design your book like this, then even one book may take you a whole week to design, because manipulating the elements that are used for creating this kind of design is not easy within Microsoft. But my job is to try to make this as easy as possible for you and for other people who are going to watch this video, so that you can design your book and make it look great, such that when a customer sees your book, they can be satisfied with your design, even if they're not satisfied with your content. Now, the book design I'm going to show you is not for cookbooks alone. It's not for cookbooks alone. I'm going to show you book designs, interior design for all types of books, including the nonfiction books. For example, this is a nonfiction book, and this is the way it starts. In fact, I use this for my cookbook when I'm doing the storytelling part. So this is how I do my story. I first write the introduction, then I start with the story. So I can go on. Then after that, I introduce my recipes. So I introduce my recipes and make sure I design the thing to look good so that the customer can be interested in reading this thing. Now, when you're designing your book, the purpose is to make sure that the information is digestible. If you just copy and paste your book and put it in Microsoft Word and just paste it, and then you edit it, you just put some simple formatting, your book will still look like a document. When your customer is reading your book, they'll be feeling like they're reading maybe some PDF from Office or something. You need to make your book look good so that it can be easily digestible and make the customer satisfied. So this is what I'm going to show you in this video. Without wasting time, let's begin. Now, to make a great book design, there are 6 elements that you need to know. So to know these elements, all you have to do, let's open this document for our tutorial. So this is the document I'm going to use for our tutorial. Now, there are 6 elements that I talked about. There are 6. The first one is called font. Yes, font. Yes, you know this font. You know about font. Font is very important when you're doing your book design. For example, if you choose the correct font, then you can make a great book interior design. Most of you are always using Times New Romans, but Times New Romans is too common. If you can see, Microsoft Word document alone has a lot of fonts which you can use. So you can just get a font from this Microsoft document and use. For example, this one's called Public Sans. It's called Public Sans. Now, this Public Sans almost looks like Times New Romans, but it is a different font. How do you get fonts for your book? The first place you can get fonts is this place. You can check here and find all the fonts you want. Now, did you know that you can actually even download fonts from the internet? So let me show you how you can download and install fonts into your book. So to download fonts, all you have to do is come to Google and type Google Fonts. As you can see, Google Fonts here. So you type and click enter. Then it will open for you this website. Now from here, all you have to do is click on this. After clicking on this, then you'll see all the types of fonts you want here. So as you can see here, this one's called Roboto. This is one of the fonts. This one's called Bricolage. Then there are these ones. As you can see, there are thousands, if not millions of fonts on this site of Google, and all of them are free to download. Now let me show you how to download and install them. For example, you see this one called Railway. If I want to download this Railway, all I have to do is click on this Railway. After clicking on this Railway, and I click on Download Family. So I click on Download Family. Now this Download Family will download all the fonts which look like it in its format. For example, the bold format, the unbold format, all of them. As you can see, it has been downloaded. Fonts are very small, usually very small, than like 3.4 MBs. So all I have to do is click on this file. Click on this file icon to show it in a folder where it is. So as you can see, it is here. So I create a new folder for it. So click here, create a new folder. As you can see the folder here. So I drag it inside the folder. After that, I open the folder and extract it. So click here, click on it, and extract it here. Click extract it here. And wait, as you can see, now it has come with 3 formats. There are like 3 formats here. Yeah, 1, 2. Actually, there are 2 formats. 1, italics, and then variable font weight. So as you first check this, this thing says read me. You click on it and read it. As you can see, it's giving you the licenses or what you can do to use it, how you can use it. So it gives you all the instructions of how to use it. So this is the license. Please read the full license, blah, 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 to understand the permission, restriction, and requirement for users, blah, blah, blah. So you can click on this and read this one at your own time. But let me show you how to install this font. So to install this font, all you have to do is come here and click on it, and then left, right click to open this. As you can see, there's install, and then there's install for all users. So that's the one you want, install for all users. What this does is that when you install for all users, it will install the font in your whole computer. Any app you open, you can find the same font inside. Whether you're opening Adobe Photoshop, whether you're opening Microsoft Word document, whether you're opening what, you can still find this font inside them. So let me install for all users. But today, we are doing it for Microsoft Word document. So as you can see, it has been installed. Now, the name is what? It's a Railway. So let's go and look for Railway inside Microsoft Word document. So if I come to my Microsoft Word document, which is here, and I try to look for Railway, and I should be able to find it by now. So Railway, try to find it. Yes, as you can see, it is now here. It's now here and it's being used. So if I move the cursor on it, you can see the things are changing inside there. So it has been installed inside my Microsoft Word document. So I can use this font. So you can simply come online and find a good font that you can use. You come here and find a good font which you can use. Here you can even use, you can test the fonts. You can do everything. You test the fonts the way you want. Here you can type your own thing and see what the font will look like. Type your things and see what the font will look like. You can even shake it. You can left align it, right align it. You can do your experiment online before you download the font. So everything is here. You can even try it in header 1, header 2. You can reduce or increase the size the way you want. You can change the color. Yes. You can test it before you actually download it. You can see the spacing, the way it will look when it is placed. So here you can get all your fonts from here. That is one big secret that you're now known. So this is where to get fonts. This is just one website. There are very many other websites like this one. So you just have to type fonts, free fonts online, then you can find them. You will get all the free fonts that are given online. So that is the first element you needed to know in this design series. First element is font. Now let's go to the next element. The next element is something called a text box. Now text box is very important in this video, because in order to write on specific part of the document, you're going to need text box. So to get a text box, all you have to do is come to insert. If you can see insert, you come to insert. After reaching insert, then you can go here and you see text box. They're here, text box. Now there are very many text boxes here, and there are even templates of text box that are already made for you. You just have to click and use. Then you can also, there's also a way for you to draw your own text box if you don't want to use the templates which are here. So let's do that and see. So to get the templates of a text box, all you have to do is come and click on this drop down arrow, click on this arrow, and you can see there are very many built in text boxes here. Let's see this first one. As you can see, this is the text box. If I want to use this text box, I have to delete everything inside and use it. As you can see, now I'm using the text box. That means you can now create anything, and then you can move it anywhere you want inside this document. So you can place it here. As you can see, you can place it here, or you can place it this side. You can place it this side, or you can place it up the way you want. You can place it anywhere you want, and the text box will stand. That is one of the text boxes. Now let me see another text box. Come to insert, go to text box and click here. As you can see, this is another type of text box. You can still use this to design your book. You can use it to design your book interior. So you can just change it. You can type anything you want inside and it will be good to go. And then you can move it the way you want. So that is text box number 2. Then there is also another type of text box, which is this one. This one, you can see, this is the one most people use to write their recipes. Yes, inside here. So you can use this text box to design and write your recipes the way you want. So all these things can be manipulated the way you want, and you end up with a good interior design. So as I've said, text box, you can even now draw. I said you can get this, you can use the template, or you can draw your own text box. So to draw your own text box, you come here to draw text box. You click on it and then you drag it, hold and drag wherever you want it to go. For example, you can drag it from here to here and you have a text box, a full text box, and you can type inside it the way you want. You can type inside it. So text box is one of the important things in this kind of design. The next element you need to know is called shapes. I've already talked about how to use shapes in one of my videos, but I will still talk about it again. So if you want to make a great design, you need to deal with shapes, and these shapes can help you in putting images inside your book design. If I want to get shapes, they're all in insert. So I have to come to insert and click on the drop down arrow to see the shapes. Now I can pick one shape and I draw it on the document. And you can see that the shapes are here. Now these shapes we use them in putting images inside our books. So if I'm using this shape to put an, for example, the kind of image where you put it on top of the document, you can do it using shape. So you come here and just drop the image. Then you come inside and click on the shape and click on shape format and then click on shape fill and click on picture. After that, from a file, you click on from a file and you insert a picture inside this shape. Let me get a picture from my desktop and insert it inside this shape so that you can see what I'm talking about. So if I get one of these images, like this one maybe, and I click insert, then you can see that the image has arrived here. So then I can crop it to fit. So picture format, and I crop and then fill. As you can see, now I can move this image the way I want. And at the end of the day, I have a great image up on top. So that is how shapes work. That is the importance of shapes in this design video. Now, the next thing I'm going to mention to you is the most important one. It's the most secret that most people use in designing these things. Now, the reason why people use this is because it is very stable. It is very stable. It makes your book stable. And that is called the tables. These tables are very important in making a great design. There are tables, templates of tables you already made, like these ones. When you click on it, you can see that they keep on coming on your document. And then you can also insert your own table or draw your own table down here or insert your own table. So if you master how to use tables, then you've mastered how to make a great, great interior design. So that is element number 5. Then element number six is called rulers and guides. Rulers and guides. These are rulers and guides. These things you're seeing up here. They're very, very important. In fact, if I'm not mistaken, they're the most important things in this book creation series, because they are the ones which are going to guide you. Now, in most cases, Amazon or any other platform want you to have those things they call gutters and trim size and blah blah. They want you to leave spaces on the sides of your book. And if you have these rulers and guides, then you can easily leave those spaces. You can design your interior without messing with those spaces. And that is what you need to know in this video. So I've introduced you to the whole book creation interior design series. And this is just the first video. And there are going to be very many videos which I'm going to create on this kind of thing.